Available from Central Park Media. Richard Nixon was the most controversial and complex man ever to hold the presidency. A master of foreign diplomacy, he opened relations with China and ended the Vietnam War. He stunned the nation with Watergate and became the first and only American president to resign. The real Richard Nixon explores the man behind the myth. Take a journey on the Silk Road, Marco Polo's ancient route to China. Produced at a cost of $50 million and over 10 years in the making, the Silk Road video collection is comprised of separate adventures linking ancient and modern-day Asia. With the entrancing music of Kitaro as a backdrop, each of the episodes in the collection focuses on the history, art, and culture of one of the world's most inaccessible regions. Broadcast to outstanding critical acclaim in over 25 countries, the Silk Road is now available on video for the first time. What really happened to Adolf Hitler at the end of World War II? Some believe Hitler escaped with Eva Braun, his mistress of 15 years, to Argentina. Still others believe Hitler survived his meeting with death and was waiting for the opportunity to unleash his death plot on an unsuspecting world. As insidious as some of these theories may seem, none could be entirely discounted until now. Hitler, the final chapter, uncovers the shocking details of Hitler's final days. Wars in Peace is a riveting account of the battles fought from Korea and Vietnam to the desert lands of Israel and Kuwait. Witness how technology changed warfare, from the use of jets in Korea to the incredible blitzkrieg of the Gulf. Great Days of the Century examines the important events of our time. Focusing on one historic event as its focal point, each episode deals with the whole story before, during, and after the event, allowing us to better understand its historic significance. June 6, 1944, D-Day, the beginning of the end. The most impressive armada ever assembled, commanded by General Eisenhower, stormed the beaches of Normandy to begin the most decisive military action in the history of the modern world. This incredible documentary retraces the remarkable events leading up to the most momentous 24 hours ever recorded on film. From the dawn of this century through 1990, this great century is a comprehensive video chronology of major advances, trends, and tragedies of the 20th century. This in-depth series features an astonishing collection of original newsreel and vintage footage. All series are available, individually or in collector's sets, from Central Park Media.
That's marvelous. Anybody else left in there? Here we go, ready or not? That's it. That's pretty.
Flex up.
That's
it. Keep your arm up now.
That's it.
Stomach in.
You look groovy. Good, Rachel. Looking good.
Okay.
Ready, carry.
A lot of energy. Lunging, do you want?
Anything is so.
That's it, Rachel. Good. Good. Okay. Again, Rachel.
Rachel's waiting for you. You're going to have to get me in the next 4 weeks. Because you've got the size over. You have more size than any girl. Best sandwich.
Got plenty of muscle there. You just got to get that water off. You got to get more cut up to win. It's all in your diet.
See, the triceps are coming out. The delts showing some. Now, we just got to get the fat off and we've got it. We'll beat her hands down.
This will be my first pro contest against 15 women that I've been looking in the magazines, tearing out pictures of. Actually, the main thing I'm excited about is being able to compete with Rachel McLeish. I don't know, a lot of you might know her as the top female bodybuilder that there is, and I've patterned myself after her, so I'm real excited about being able to pose down with Rachel. It'd be Rachel and I on the stage is my dream, and then they announce me as the winner, of course.
Oh, yeah, very good. It's improved. Presentation is going to make you win or lose. Movement. Little flash dance in there. Okay, all right. There you go. Little flash dance. You think you're as good as last year. All the work you did this year, like commercials, you think that that's taken the drive and the hunger away, being that, you know, you went through a lot of fame and... You know, and all that, you think that sort of made you a little soft, a little powder puffish?
Well, I've always considered myself a powder puff, but I consider myself a really strong powder puff. Mm-hmm. Can't you tell by looking at these muscles?
Oh, it looks good, it looks good. But then again, we're only looking at you now. We don't know what you're going to face that night. I don't want to mention the younger girls, but I'm just saying.
I happen to be one of the younger
girls.
Well,
wait a minute now. What do you mean? I mean, they could be real young. I think that
the younger the better. That means they have less experience, less muscle development, and less know-how in general. So, bring them in.
Here you go. Get in camp. Got 1 month. There you go. Come on. There you go. Come on. Good one. Head over there. Sit down. Good shit. Let's go. Let's get me. Come on. Go.
This last one help.
Come on. Come on. Get me, man. Get me.
Still Susan Powell's looking at you.
Come on. Go.
You got it.
Get chair. Come on.
That's it. You're fine. What it is. So, if you're ready for Caesars?
There's a lot of pressure there. Are you going to be able to put up with it?
I love pressure.
Rachel's going to be ready, too.
I am going to be more ready. That's right. I'm looking out.
What are you going to do when you beat Rachel?
I haven't quite decided what I'm going to do with all that money, but I know Randy will quit dancing.
Oh,
Enjoy it, darling. I'm going to get you out of this soon. I can't stand it any longer.
Can't either. It's hot out there.
You look too good up there, okay? Can you ease off? Please, for a moment.
Sure.
Sorry, I'm late.
Oh, you're sorry. 2 hours.
Ew.
I just kissed your earring.
Oh. Well, let's sit down and eat.
No, I know. I just came from the gym, and I just found out that Bev, it's for sure, Bev Francis is going to compete in this contest.
Who?
In December, yeah.
Well, who's Bev Francis?
Well, that's right. You guys don't know anything about her. She's this Australian powerlifter who has got to be the most muscular woman I have ever seen. I mean, she's 180 pounds now. I mean, the last time I saw any pictures of her, if she comes down to a really good competitive weight, then she'll just be outrageous. She's got muscularity that most men wish they had. And it's just something that the judges up until now have never seen. It's rumored that Rachel is supposed to win this contest, but I don't know, with somebody like Bev around.
Are you worried?
No, because it's competition. I mean, it's a game.
So it's just somebody else to compete against, right?
Yeah. I'd really, at some point, I guess I would really like to look like Bev.
It's a challenge.
But on a different frame.
Did you order anything?
All right, well, I thought, seeing you're married now, you might take a different viewpoint of things.
You haven't been on that green leafy stuff since then.
No.
What are you doing here?
Well, I was on my way to training, and I thought, what better thing to do on the day after your honeymoon than to come for a rigorous training session?
Look who's here, Nige.
I'm just going to concentrate just on the bodybuilding, just for the contest. I'm going to really go in there really good. Really good. There's nothing else on my mind, you know?
That's right.
Nothing else on my mind. Except maybe after the contest.
Yeah.
Then
play up.
Yeah, play up a bit.
Well, Las Vegas is the place.
Yeah.
Come on!
Kilos.
Yeah.
Come on. That was so fast. Come on. That was so easy. That was fast. If it's hard, it's going to be slow.
Yeah.
It just went,
yeah.
Come on. Come on.
Yeah. Easy.
Beautiful.
Next, Bev Francis.
Thank you. I want some help with my belt.
Former ballet dancer, now one of Australia's finest athletes, will attempt to lift 510 pounds. Second attempt to lift, the world's strongest woman.
Come on.
Holds about 30 or 40 world records, I'm not quite sure what.
Come on.
Come on, Bev, let's go.
I always felt that I was a little bit different. I used to like different things from the other little girls. I was a bit of a tomboy, which means I liked playing boys' games, I liked playing football, I liked climbing things. I always admired strength in anything, whether it was human or animal or the weather, or I love thunderstorms and anything that's big and strong and powerful. And I always wanted to be powerful myself. I used to do things that people thought were really dumb as a little kid, like try and go without drinking water for a whole day, or sort of things that I thought would toughen me up. I felt that I was a little bit different, but I never had the confidence in myself to think that I could be better, to think that I could be the strongest woman in the world or anything like that. And it was only in later years, when I came across other people who encouraged me and who led me into the right field, and who finally convinced me that things were possible, and all you had to do was really have the belief in yourself and do the work, and you might make it. And it was a joy to get stronger.
Hi, Dad.
Hello, Shane. How are you?
All right.
Yeah,
hi.
Welcome.
Hi, Mum.
Hi.
Hi, Cinnamon.
Hi.
How do you like your new sister?
Oh, she's cute.
She's beautiful, isn't she?
This will be the first time I've gone to Las Vegas. The competition's going to be in Caesar's Palace, which I haven't been there, but you've seen enough, you know, functions that have been there. It's a pretty classy sort of flash place. So it'll be even more scary. If it was in some dingy backroom gym, I'd feel more at home. But so it'll be nice to win. It's quite a few $1,000 in it.
It's not trophies like you've
heard. No, it's not those horrific, horrendous trophies. In the past, all the winners have been women that, to me, aren't really bodybuilders. They're thin. They're sort of more...
sinewy.
Yeah, they look like ballet dancers or gymnasts, like Cinnamon. Mm. They're still not what I call bodybuilders. Now, I'm going to go in to try and really get big and train like just like a male bodybuilder would. But what, if the judges like it or not, that's, I don't know.
Well, we wish you all the best, Beth.
I don't want you to have any mercy on me whatsoever.
I'm not going to.
God has nothing to do with them not being able to complete a repetition.
Shit!
What?
One more. Come on, look straight ahead. Come on. Good. Beautiful. Up slow.
Come on.
Dolly Parton, here we come.
What?
One more by yourself. Come on. You got it. You want it. Up. Up. Okay, now just press down. Whatever you do, okay? Sit. Tense your butt and come up. A little deeper, you're losing it. Come on. That's it.
So she must be pretty big.
Hope she knows what she's in for. You know, you never trained a woman before.
I know, but I'm gonna train her like I've trained anybody. I don't care if she's a woman. I'll train her as hard as I've trained any man.
You know, this is a challenge for me too. It's gonna be rough.
Yeah.
Let's say we go meet her.
I think this is her.
Yeah, that's her. Oh my God! Look at her size. Let's go.
Bev Francis?
Hi, I'm Steve Mihalik. Welcome to America.
Thanks, Steve.
I want you to meet my friend here, Big Steve. He trains with me. He's a powerlifting enthusiast.
Hi, Steve.
How you doing? I've read a lot about you.
Good things, I hope.
All good. How was your trip?
It was long and tiring, but it was okay.
So what do you want to do? You want to get some rest, or you want to go take a look at the gym?
I'd like to look at the gym. You know, I didn't come here to just lie around in bed, so let's get into it. Huh?
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
I know you can do this. You know, I know. I know because I've studied your body long enough. I know you can do this.
Okay.
This is child's play for you. You gotta be kidding. The only way we're gonna get that extra half inch on your chest is if we get these up.
Okay.
Let's do it in 2 steps, right? Come on. Now, you do not accept defeat. You do these. Let's go. Come on. Let's throw them back on your chest as you lean down. I got you. Come on. Atta, girl. Now do them. I'll get you started. Ready? Go. Oh, come on, boy. Really good. Come on. Huge muscles, man. We're going to be limited by no time. Come on. We're going to be beaten by nobody. The person that puts out the most gets the most. Do it! Don't give in. Don't even doubt it for a second. Come on. Now. Okay, just put them down. Dump them. Come on, drive it up there. 7. Each rep is that pose on stage. Visualize it. 8. Okay, come on. 9. One more. All right, hold this up here, okay? Come on. Get strong here. Here, here, push out, push out. Good. Let's go. Let's do it. Blank it out. Come on, blank out the pain. Don't give in. Fight me. Fight me. Fight me. Good. Relax. Good set. Battle of the sexes. It's all right. Okay. Good. How'd that weight feel?
Hard.
Good. Let's add 5 pounds.
Take it from the beginning, first shot. All right? You hear? And twist up. Good. Turn. Back. Left. And clear.
I've been a dancer.
Come on, let's try it one more time.
They're gonna be humiliated. Forget about it. Everybody else put their pants on and went home.
I want to really shock people.
You're gonna.
Oh, you are.
In a good way.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt about it.
I want to show them that a woman can develop muscle and still look like a woman and look strong and look like a statue, like a Greek god.
We're gonna do that in just 11 more days.
It's going good. It's going real good. But I'm tired. I'm very
Look,
tired.
You really do. I'm training like an animal. A monster, just unchained.
That's what I like to do.
That's what you're doing. I'm doing it real good.
So, we're gonna do it, kid.
Yep, you and me, what a team. I've still got to survive another 11 days,
right.
But I'm gonna do it.
I'm gonna do it. I know you got it.
Whatever it takes.
I don't even know how to play one game with cards, believe it or not. I have no idea.
Oh, really?
I don't really want to learn.
Oh, good. Then you don't know how to cheat at strip poker then, do you?
This is fantastic. Like something from outer space.
But imagine if there was a power failure out here.
Oh, that would be tragic.
There would be one whole area on the map would disappear.
Completely.
Yeah.
Even the legs.
The legs?
Yeah.
Wait till you see my legs. You ain't seen nothing yet. You know how fat my legs were?
Your legs were never fat. My goodness.
It's amazing.
Isn't it?
You've got your haircut.
Yeah.
Your head's as skinny as my body.
That's still long, look.
Yeah. Gee, it's great to have you here. I really missed you. I haven't been homesick, but I've missed people, you know?
Come on in, look at this room.
Wow.
A round bed, a shower right in the middle.
This is nice.
This is great. Pink. You look here, D.
No, it's pink.
A round bed. Did you get that job?
No, I looked for a bunch of them, but...
Oh, hopefully you won't need it.
Hopefully.
Listen to this. Dear Bev, giving this letter to Gail enables us to be in touch just before the big event, so to get straight to the point, all, and I mean all, the family, with Dad and I, wish you all the very best in your debut as a bodybuilder. And as it's theatrical, I'll remind you of a few theatre hints. Smile when possible to denote you are enjoying what you are doing, but let your facial expressions complement your movements. Build to a good finish and end with chin up and go off proud. If you are nervous, take deep breaths before you start. You probably know all these things, but perhaps forgotten one or some of them. And this one's from Dad. So it's up to you now, love. We know you'll do your very best. I'm already looking forward to your homecoming. Cheerio for now. May all your dreams come true, your loving Dad. Isn't that nice?
Well, that's some letter, huh?
Yeah, isn't that nice?
What a mum.
That's my dad.
What a mum, what a dad.
Dad, mum was the theatrical advice, and Dad was the, we're behind your kid, you know? Isn't that nice?
I'm ready to try some of those restaurants out I'm seeing down there. Look at all the buffets. I can't think of anything but food at the moment.
It's pretty neat, though.
Yeah. Puts a nice ending to my day. And you being here.
You think you'd like to get married here?
Yeah. Yes.
Are you sure here?
Well, I mean, anywhere with you, I guess. I would have never thought Vegas, because everybody gets, you know, Vegas is kind of, but sure. That'd be great. You take me to eat?
Thank you.
hard work.
Anyone know or want to say who's going to win this?
Who's going to win? I'm going to win. Come on. You think I built this up for nothing?
What do you think of Beth Francis, who's competing?
I'm really surprised to see her.
It's going to be interesting. I don't know whether it will be a dilemma for the judges or not.
Probably, it always is.
It's always been a dilemma.
I hope, really, that they stick with, you know, the feminine look. Instead of
muscular. Still
yeah,
muscular,
but I mean, not
it's his bodybuilding
huge.
After all.
Yeah, I mean, a woman's a woman. That's my philosophy, though. I think she should look like a woman.
I think
when you lose that, what's the point of being a woman still, except for in this sport?
Just don't forget, it's bodybuilding. It's not model building, if you call it that.
It's not a model.
We're talking about a developed shape. We're not talking about God's given shape. We're talking about a shape that's been created in the gym through hard work.
Right.
And, you know, I happen to believe in bodybuilding, and I happen to believe that you can create a very beautiful feminine shape with bodybuilding.
Right. Where we go in doing the best and looking the best that we possibly can. We have nothing to feel bad about. We place 10th. We have nothing to feel bad about.
And that's why the competition is great, because we make friends, we can talk.
And we sit here and we talk.
Yeah.
We have a fun time.
Judges I've not worked with before, so we'll have to go through the mechanics as well.
Yeah, that's very important.
Because mm-hmm. I'm not too sure whether this guy Sanchez has done the placing system. Yeah. You know?
Let me see what they know about.
We hope that this evening we can clear up the definite meaning, the analysis of the word femininity, and what you have to look for. This is an official IFBB analysis of the meaning of that word. What we're looking for is something that's right down the middle, a woman that has a certain amount of aesthetic femininity, but yet have that muscle tone to show that she's an athlete.
I object to being told that there is a certain point beyond which women can't go in the sport. When you say that they should look athletic but not too masculine, what does that mean exactly? I mean, it's as though the U.S. Ski Federation told women skiers that they could only ski so fast.
We want what's best for our sport and best for our girls. And we don't want to turn people on. We want to off. We want to turn them on.
We are in the 1980s, gentlemen. I mean, who are we to say what looks like a woman and what doesn't? And who are we to say
that a
woman can only go so
far? Come on, you guys. One day we should talk to all the judges all over the world together, because this thing here happens every time we have one judge we haven't seen for 2 or 3 years.
The fact is, this is a watershed competition, in the sense that in this competition, we all know this, there's no point in talking around it, there will be a female bodybuilding competitor who has gone beyond what any other woman bodybuilder has so far presented.
We're here to protect the majority and protect our sport. If you have the majority of the girls that absolutely say, hey, let's go for these big, grotesque muscles and let's go to the ultimate, so be it, okay? But we are following what the majority wants. I just want to say that women are women and men are men, and there's a difference, and thank God for that difference. That's all I have to say.
Thank you.
so many things in bodybuilding that everybody else is, you know, just discovering or just learning or instinctive for me because of synchronized swimming. They're so parallel.
Bodybuilding has always appealed because it's kind of, it's put those things together that I love.
Mm-hmm.
And, involving strength and, because I love muscles. I just love muscularity.
I've always had them. I've always had to deal with, you know, kids. Even the guys on the gymnastics team would come to me and say, ooh, make a muscle. And
yeah.
The kids in the summer day camp would, oh, there's muscle lady, yeah.
So, Carla, what do you honestly think of my chances in this?
Believe it or not, most of your male judges will go for the more muscular physique.
Yeah, I think so.
The female judges will be one way or another. If you're muscular and, quote unquote, what they think is a feminine physique,
yeah,
then you have a very good chance. And they don't make a point of making a clear separation between sexuality and sensuality.
Yeah, that's right.
And many people just totally fail to make that differential between sensuality and what is so important anyway. I mean, if we are that shallow in our relationships to people, and if femininity only depends on having muscles or not having muscles, then what happens to the woman who, let's say, has to have a mastectomy? We have become so inured to the Playboy centerfold image,
yeah,
that it's really a slap in the face to women, because women come in all shapes and sizes and whatnot, and yet so few of our images are accepted. It's just this one narrow image that's accepted.
It's the commercial.
And it's not real.
Commercial image.
And it's not real.
Dumbbells really don't move. Look at the dumbbells. They ain't moving. They're just twisting. See? All right. See? Dumbbells ain't going anywhere. They're just in their own little orbit. See, look. They don't move. One little fulcrum point. She's doing the work.
One more. Come on, Dad. Squeeze him up. Come on.
You know, the question here is not how she did it, but where she's at right now. And I just asked her, what does bodybuilding mean to you? I mean, how do you feel on stage, and what do you want to exude?
So what she said?
Well, first I told her that what I wanted, you know, I said, when I'm on stage, I want every woman to just want to look like me or try to achieve what I've done, have a perfect body. I visualize like the caricatures in comic books, right, with tiny little waists and perfect legs with little muscles, but,
right,
you know, they look like Wonder Woman.
Right.
But,
So what'd she say?
Well, she thought for a while, and then she said that she's taken it a step beyond that. She gave me the impression that she had the perfect feminine muscular body, and she decided to take it, you know, further.
Feminine.
It seemed to me like she skipped this point.
The question is whether or not society, our culture, the judges, the audience, the layperson out there is ready for a pioneer like that.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this.
I respect her immensely. I just am very, very curious what the hell those seven people are going to do when they're judging this contest.
We all are.
Really rich. Beautiful. Wayne, do we have all our competitors here, please?
Will each competitor please bring her bikini forward?
I have to see it. I want to make sure, and so do you.
My normal, up around my cuticus.
One color is fine. No bangles or anything.
It's Rachel that's the problem.
I know you.
Yep. Sorry.
Don't have anything that's plain. It doesn't,
I'm afraid that's not acceptable. It's not a plain material. The rules require it to be made of one color, plain material. Do you have another?
No, I don't. I had this one, well, made myself, and I spent many hours on it. And it wasn't metallic. It's just gonna look shiny on stage.
You have until tomorrow to get a new suit. And now if we can proceed with the meeting.
But we need to define feminine as it applies to our sport. I mean, if we're not accepting passivity as the basis of definition of femininity, then We've got to put some sort of perimeter around the word.
The very first sentence in the women's rulebook really covers it. Judges must remember that they are judging a women's contest, and the competitors must still look like women.
We all have our ideas of femininity.
If they go to extremes and start looking like men, that's not what we're looking for in a women's contest. It's the results of the competition that will act as a guide. And so the judges are being regularly briefed so that they don't, as Ben says, go to the extremes. And it's the winners of the competition who will set what you might call the standard of femininity.
Bodybuilders. What do you know?
The old men bodybuilders, yeah.
Yeah. Or a typical European bodybuilder.
The men always run out of poses, you know. What'll I do next? And they're walking around the stage. Throwing an Arnold, yeah.
I wanted to tell you, I feel kind of awkward here I sit talking to you, you know. When I've looked at your pictures for so long, I really have kind of patterned myself after you. I don't know if you knew or noticed or what, but...
Well, I have
noticed. I've really been anxious to be on stage with you. You know, you're really competitive.
Well, I'm sure Randy helps me out quite a bit.
Oh, yes, yes. It's just been him and I the whole way. So it's like part of him is up there with me, you know.
Surely.
So.
With Christian and I would marry him in a second, but I don't feel I know him well enough.
You're not quite ready
and
yet.
Well, the most important thing to me is he has to have one thing that's as important to him as it is to me, and that's to, you know, love the Lord more than anything in or out of this world. Because when you put that first in your life, your priorities and your values are in the correct order. And it says in the Bible, well, I take the Bible as, you know, the absolute truth and the Word of God, and that's what it says time and time again. And I follow it, and it's guided me throughout this crazy bodybuilding career of mine.
Yes. Well, I wish you luck. I mean,
yeah, same to
that
you.
Sounds funny, but I...
It really doesn't. I mean, I wish the best
but
for everybody.
But I mean well.
I know you do. Same to you.
It sure has. And this is really what I thought it would be, Dan. Two fighters at close range banging away.
They sure are, Bruce. And there's the end of round three. Just a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow night we'll be bringing you the Caesars World Cup for Women, the richest bodybuilding competition in history. You won't want to miss this championship featuring muscular beauties from the world over. That's tomorrow night at 8, right here in Las Vegas.
Christian?
Yes?
In a few hours, I'm gonna be on stage.
Yeah, here it is, the last night before the contest.
Remember what we were talking about?
When?
The anticlimactic feeling of Singapore.
Yeah.
You know, you spent an entire year
right.
training and striving, and all of a sudden, it was over. Is it strange to feel that way before it even happens? I'm feeling really anticlimactic the day before the show. I can't believe that. I've never felt this way before. Issues. I guess I'm getting kind of scared now.
Scared?
Well, I'm worried, you know.
No time to get scared. You should be confident, huh?
Yeah.
Is Rachel's routine different, or it's just as voluptuous? I mean, she's appealing to the men, who just happen to be 95% of the judges. That's what I saw that. That was my first time seeing her. I knew exactly who she was playing up to. Little Patty Lips.
I love you.
Does it smell?
It smells like marijuana in here.
Smelled like that in the hallway before. She's a
me if I'm ready for this.
10 minutes. 10 minutes, girls.
Just put your hands away from do a pose in the back. Just want to see where the suit.
Yes, higher. On the oblique line. Yes.
Good luck, but I can't. Okay.
Okay. See ya.
Okay.
Want to see your face out there.
Okay. I'm trying to get this lipstick off your teeth. Off your teeth.
Yeah.
Come to me, relax. I'll be out there. Look for me.
Okay.
You ready, girls? Follow me out, please, in one line. Please be careful walking down the steps. Please do not trip. Let's go.
What do you think, though?
She's magnificent. Oh, she's so perfect and so beautiful.
And now, introducing our MC for this evening, the one and only George Clinton.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Caesar's Palace and to the richest women's bodybuilding contest of all time, the Caesar's World Cup. The total prize money is $50,000, with a winner's share of $25,000. I might add, that is equivalent to the largest prize ever offered in any bodybuilding contest, either male or female. And that's a fairly good indication of how far women's bodybuilding has come in such a very short period of time. So, if we're ready, let's meet the competitors.
Now we shall bring them forward two or three at a time while the judges make their comparisons.
2, 7, 11. I want three of them out.
Number 2, Tina Plackinger. Number 7, Rachel McClure. Number 11, Carla Dunn. Double biceps, please. Side chest.
There's a big difference in body changes with those three, isn't there?
Yeah. Yeah.
Different waistlines.
Yeah.
And...
Great number two. Ripped.
Woo!
Thank you. Thank you.
Six, seven?
Mm-hmm.
The whole tour?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Number six, Bev Francis. Number seven, Rachel McLeish. Double biceps, please. Side chest. Back double biceps.
Total opposites.
Come on, Bev.
That's it. That's it.
Hold it high.
High fives, baby.
Side triceps. Side triceps.
Tuesday, Bev.
Leg back, please, Rachel. No extra poses. Just the one I called.
Rachel's gonna fight for this one.
Abdominals and legs.
Oh, you can bet on that.
Thank you. Thank you. Shelley Grove.
There's nobody next to her.
Nobody.
Nobody.
God,
it's just her and people next to her.
Rachel must feel like Napoleon did.
She's crying.
God, don't you love it? Number six, Bev Francis, please. Number 11, Carla Dunlap.
New Jersey.
Back double bicep.
Come on, Bev.
Take your time, honey.
Take your time and hit it hard.
Yeah.
That's hard.
Okay, just take your time. They're gonna need some orange juice.
I'm fine.
Ready to go back?
Yeah.
So she feels much better.
Abdominals and legs.
Bang! Come on!
Defense.
That's it!
Slow motion. Slow motion.
That concludes the prejudging the first round. There will be a pause for a few moments while we examine the judges' mark sheets, and then we will begin our second round. Thank you, ladies.
Take your time. Don't miss that one.
Good. Watch me. Nice.
Drunk on stage. I thought, you know, Cherry Liqueur, high sugar.
Good news, any alcohol should be white wine or like a bourbon or something. Never on high sugar stuff because it'll knock you out. You'll go.
I mean, in the muscularity round, she's the most muscular.
Then she should get one.
Yeah, but then you shouldn't talk to the judges the way you do at the meeting.
But I told them in the first round,
because
looking for
over the,
Jack, yeah, I didn't mention anything about femininity when I told them what to look for on the first round. I said, look for muscularity.
Yeah, but if it's too much, you said.
This is why we get criticized by the audience. I mean, this audience
they
went
look
nuts
for someone
over muscles. That's what they were here to see. That's what we're judging.
This man hated it, isn't
it? Tell me how to do.
Good. Very good.
How did I compare?
What?
How did I compare?
Tremendously good. I'm not objective. For me, you are the winner.
But do you look at it for who's got the biggest muscles?
Muscularity is only a part of it. Obviously, it's bodybuilding, and of course we look at the muscles. That's the main thing, but not necessarily who has the biggest.
What do you think it would do if Bev Francis were to win this contest?
I think it would be a total disaster, and I think the sport would just totally go in reverse. It's growing by leaps and bounds. Women are interested in weight training. Every woman I've ever met has wanted to improve her body, but Bev Francis does not look like a woman. She does not represent what women want to look like.
Who do you think will win this contest?
Oh, there's three or four competitors that are very good. It's very close. I think Rachel will probably win.
Unfortunately, there's been a complaint filed against you about your suit. A question of padding and size.
Well, you can check it. That's what Doris, like.
Doris is here to check.
It's, you know, it's just double.
It's the best
it's thick. It is a thickness in here. Well,
is there any way that can come out?
That's the way it's made. Sorry.
Do you have another suit?
Yes, I do. I'd love to wear it. Except I think it's disqualified.
Because of the sequins?
Uh-huh.
Can you take the padding out?
It's sewn. It's the material. It's just thicker than, you know, the other one.
Well, you will be penalized in points.
For
as well
points?
As one from each judge.
For only this round or for
the previous round, too.
The previous rounds,
yes,
before I even knew anything? How can that be fair?
You were wearing an illegal suit. So
it wasn't illegal until right now.
It's been illegal all the way through. It's been discovered now.
What options do I have? I mean, I can wear
well,
this
the other
suit,
option is to make
wear
some
the
effort.
Other suit and be penalized as well.
No, that's even more illegal than the one you've got on now. The other option is to,
wait a
to
minute,
attempt to remove
how
the
how illegal is illegal, an illegal suit?
When you wear that, it'll be far more distracting than the one you've got on now.
Someone can help her out?
Thank you, Oscar. You just make things really interesting around here.
That's an alternative, no doubt.
Yeah, I'm the one in the doghouse, though, for trying to keep the rules.
Something
all I'm doing
implants.
Is applying the rules, Joe.
What about the girls with implants?
Look, Joe, that's not unconsideration at all. The decision on implants was to ignore that situation because it's too difficult for judges to decide who has and who hasn't implants.
I'll volunteer for the job.
Don't make a big
mistake. How am I going to cut this? I mean, I put them in there to cover up my nipple. This is going to be obscene. Oh, they want illegal. They're going to see illegal. They're going to see a see-through top.
After showing me two illegal bikinis, she appeared on stage in a black one.
Well, that's all right.
But the one she's wearing, the black one,
is
also illegal.
Why?
It's padded.
Bunch just deduct a point for each of the rounds.
I'll do
that.
You
deducted 10 points.
That's what I want to do.
Yeah, okay, but you said just the opposite to her. And Doris Barlow was there.
I didn't say
the opposite. And I was there.
Jack,
you
I
said,
know what I say. I told her to go and remove the padding.
You told her to remove the padding, and you said we don't speak about the other rounds then.
I did not.
Ask her. Doris was there, and I was there. I'm not a fool. Okay? And it's not only your way, it's the way we want it also, sometimes.
You're starting to line up, Rachel.
Yeah. Check this.
You didn't need
that's
to, after
girls.
All.
I just, it's no big deal. I mean, I just figured, is that okay?
There's a ridge right here that's going to show. Can it's you do anything with that?
It's because of the way it was made.
That's the best I can do. You checked it, so go tell Oscar. Where's Oscar? Maybe he should check it. Oscar?
Okay, girls, you want to follow me down?
And now, our contestants will perform one by one in the free pose. Up first, Tina Flackinger. Bev, having reshaped her body from that of a 181-pound powerlifter to a 145-pound bodybuilder, is making her competitive debut.
Wait for the light.
Bev Francis.
Thank you.
my bed hoe, right?
What?
I'm taking my bed hoe.
And now, Rachel McLeish.
Girl?
What do you think? Am I gonna answer that?
Was my feminine quality enough there?
I think so.
When I hit that much muscle, I thought, oh, they're gonna say this is too masculine.
No, no.
Not allowed to have muscles, you're a girl.
They gotta come after you now.
Mama.
Plackinger, USA. Chris Alexander, USA. Bev Francis, Australia. Rachel McLish, USA. Carla Dunlap, USA. Laurie Bowen, USA. Mario Salin, Finland. Shelley Gruhl, USA. And now, free poses. final score. There will be an exhibition to cover the gap.
Stuck in the staircase. People wanted to talk to him, so I lost track of him afterwards.
Well, you're checking both of us. You're checking Wayne as he calls out the numbers.
He calls out the numbers.
And you check me as I write them down.
Okay.
And then all three of us we check the high and low and the totals.
Yeah. All we have to do is wait for him.
Wait for Wayne.
You sure you don't need a calculator?
Well, if I can do it as fast as that, it's as fast as tapping.
Oscar, it's not sufficient 16. To do it the way we're doing it. All right. I'll get my adding machine and we'll do it over one more time.
All right.
Now let's double check it by using the calculator.
Okay, have you got one out?
No. Did you have one, Oscar?
I left it in my room. Did you bring yours with
you? My room. Okay, then I think I have one.
You have one? All right, yes, okay. We'll wait for you to bring yours. Okay. We'll tap them out. Frances has caused a problem. I mean, she's got two judges have given her one the first round.
All the more reason why we must be extremely careful with the
selection of judges.
Yes.
Well, I agree.
Because, you know, they didn't understand what they were told.
Where's your clear?
C.
Where is it? C. It's not clearing.
Well, what I'd suggest is why don't you just double add it, because this is complicated. It's too complicated, Oscar.
And judging in bodybuilding is a complex and difficult thing to do, apparently. And so they're thrashing away. It'll be about 5 minutes.
I cleared it. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was the CE is not the clear. It's the top one. Okay. Start again.
You have 12, 13, 12,
12, 13. 62. I get here.
61.
Up on the second step.
The judges, I'm told, are now coming down the stairs from seclusion. We'll have to take a look at them as they come out. They may look somewhat different than when they went into the judging room. And our eight finalists.
Up with the curtain, up with the curtain.
In our tradition, we start with the lowest place. We'll be receiving $400. And eighth place goes to Bev Francis, Australia.
Forget about this sport bodybuilding. What the hell are they looking for? Miss America?
In seventh place, Shelley Grewer. In sixth place, Maya Selin, Finland. In fifth place, Chris Alexander, USA. In fourth place, receiving $4,000, Laurie Bowen, USA. And in third place goes to Rachel McLeish.
No! There's no way the girl is in third place. There's no way the girl is in third place.
$6,000 in cash, chips or check?
I'll take the envelope.
You take the envelope.
Not the cash.
Not the cash.
Rachel took the check. In second place, taking $10,000, either in cash, check, or in chips. And in second place, Tina Plackenton. Caesar's Palace World Cup for Women with $25,000. Tala Dunlap, USA.
Tala, come take your money and your prizes.
And to Tala Dunlap, it's been the grand slam. The World Championship, Miss Olympia, and the Caesar's World Cup.
I feel very numb right now.
You do? Can I borrow $1,000 from you? Or maybe you can get $2,000. I love it. It's a great challenge, but let's move on to other things. And I can't, I've got to be realistic. My gosh, I can't expect to win all the time, and you know, you're dealing with human beings, with human emotions. You really can't depend on them. It even says so in the Bible. I just like to depend on the real important things, like, you know, God, Jesus, the Bible, because that is what's important to me.
Honey, I'll put too much honey on.
Quick, quick.
I mean, just imagine if you really sort of counted on this, if it was sort of life and death just to win it, those judges, what they would have done to you tonight. God, they can't accept a new concept.
New concept, that is bodybuilding. The girl with the biggest muscle, with the most
and
shape,
the
and the girl that could pose. What new concept? No new concept.
It was a good response, though.
The booze?
Yeah.
I felt good with the booze. I knew the crowd was with me. Yeah, I knew the crowd would be with me.
Steak. Broiled steak. Maybe roast pork.
Choose what you want.
Anybody else want anything to eat?
No, thank you.
Lost your appetite, huh?
Yeah.
I'll just have a steak, I think, and some French fries, some coffee.
What do you think, Steve?
There's nothing to say. Same old story.
Room service?
Just kicking a pretty girl.
Italian food.
That they call pretty. Well, Carla's got a little bit of muscle. I mean, it's not like she's
a
skinny toothpick.
Like,
a Tina Plackinger?
Cut steak.
What did Tina Plackinger have over Bev? What did Carla have over Bev? You tell me. Maybe I don't see nothing. Maybe I'm stupid. What? You explain it to me.
Medium.
Explain
you.
It to me.
Yeah.
Explain it to me.
Bodies to come.